To discuss that more, we are joined by Mr. Max Egan, radio host and political commentator. Thank you very much, Mr. Egan. I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly. What is your take on this recent development? Who do you think is to blame for the halt in the negotiations?
Well, look, people have to put this in context. Israel will never allow negotiations. Israel does not want peace. It's not on the Israeli agenda to have a ceasefire. It never has been. You know, any terms that are put forth, any ceasefire that is ever negotiated, any terms that are ever negotiated, aren't going to go forward until you're allowed to have Palestinian people there negotiating as well, until the Palestinian people are given equal say on what they want to happen with their land in their country and what they want the terms to be. Because at the moment, the terms are always complete Israeli domination. And if that is allowed, if a ceasefire is ever allowed to occur under Israeli conditions, it will see the expulsion of the rest of Palestine, because the conditions will be that Israel rules the roost and will continue to put settlements in West Bank and will retake Gaza and the human rights abuses this nation is carrying out.
Mr. Egan, on the other hand, we've seen Hamas vowing to stage more protests on the Gaza borders. Are you predicting any escalation in tensions between Israel and Hamas and basically the protesters that are demanding the right to return?
Yeah, of course, there will be more violence. I mean, Israel will see that there is, but I don't trust Hamas either. I mean, on one hand, Hamas is necessary for the Palestinians to have some form of resistance, but on the other hand, it will never achieve anything. These protests on the border will not achieve anything except international condemnation for Israel having terrorists at their borders, because that's the way the Western media always portrays it. So it always plays into the hands of Israel because of the way the media portrays the situation. You know, there needs to be, people need to step back from this, and there needs to be international attention put on it. And for the UN, like I said, to have any credibility to take control of the situation. Now, all Hamas does by doing this, unfortunately, is give Israel the excuse it needs to keep the violence escalated. I mean, people have to understand all the mainstream news services in the West are all controlled and all influenced by Israel very, very significantly. You just got to look at the owners of all of these news services, and that's not any conspiracy theory, it's simply a fact. So whatever Hamas does, people are not going to get the right information. So I don't think it's the right approach, and you know, ultimately it's the people of Gaza who suffer, and it's not going to really achieve anything. But it will definitely escalate the tensions, and Israel will make sure it does, because Israel will play it that way. Anything the Palestinians do, Israel portrays as a terror attack and just does what it wants and uses it as another excuse to steal more land or kill more children in Gaza.
Thank you very much, Mr. Max Egan, radio host and political commentator, joining us live from Brisbane. Your comments are always welcome, sir, on Press TV.